We are here because this is where the battles are fought to decolonize education in Africa. And decolonization of education does not mean that we must be taught in Xhosa. You can't be taught in Xhosa and be taught wrong things. Decolonized education does not mean being taught in mother tongue. It means that we ought to liberate the syllabus, the content, must liberate the mind of African children. The education system, every time it gives you examples, it gives you examples of whiteness and project whiteness as excellence. And all of you, when you graduate, you want to be like white people. That is the type of education we are fighting. We don't want education that gives examples of whiteness as a center of excellence. When we say we decolonize, we mean that Africans should learn about their own experiences and learn how they are going to defeat and better those experiences. Because if decolonization, Vuyani, means that we must be taught in Xhosa, then Bible is written in Xhosa as well, yet projects Christianity as white. We are not accommodated there. That's why even Jesus Christ is projected as white, even in a Xhosa written Bible. It's not a language that matters. It is the content. And therefore, we ought to get the content right. The youth of 1976, when they fought against Africans, it was not because they didn't want to go to school. They knew that the colonizer wanted to make them in his own image. Colonialism, chairperson, in simple terms, is when the colonizer makes you in his or her image. What is the image of our colonizer in South Africa? Is to bleach ourselves and want to look white. What is the image of colonialism in South Africa? Is to straighten our hair and want to look white. What is colonialism in South Africa? Is to want to speak English better than the English themselves, because you think English is better than Xhosa itself. One, the colonizer has made you in their image. You must walk like them. You must speak like them, you must write like them, you must dress like them. And anything else that doesn't show the image of a colonizer, it's a taboo. What is a taboo here in Alice? When we slaughter and perform rituals for our ancestors, we are ashamed because it's not the image of a colonizer. We have never seen a white man slaughtering and performing rituals, therefore it is wrong. One, you are made in the image of the colonizer, and therefore in everything else you do, you want to be like your colonizer. So when we say we are decolonizing education, we ultimately want to decolonize society so that we embrace ourselves. And listen to me, I never said a person who bleached herself or himself is not an African. If you want to do it, do it. As long as it comes from inside, it's what you like. But don't do it because you want to look like your mother's boss. You must do it because for some reason you feel fulfilled. As long as it comes from inside you, straighten your hair. Not because you want to look like Helen Zille. She's not one of the best people you want to look like. Be happy when you've got a black client in front of you. Don't give a cheap service to your own black brothers and sisters. You must know that these people have suffered a lot. When you see a black person, whether in a tie, whether in a shirt, torn shirt, we are all the same. Including Patrice Motsepe, by the way. We are like him. He can have all his money. He's black, he's hated, he doesn't know. Until he wears a white t-shirt into a white restaurant. Say, that's right. Someone must go and whisper to them and say, hey, it's a different black this one. But before that, we are all the same. Treat our people with dignity as a graduate, as a service provider. Always make sure that your job which you do for black people is excellent and perfect. Go an extra mile of asking, how are the children at home? We just want someone to listen. We're so troubled. We're so rejected and dejected to a point that we can't talk to anyone. That's why we're killing ourselves. Because everyone is too busy to listen. Listen to the black sisters and brothers. They don't want your money. They want someone to listen and sympathize. Because we're a traumatized nation.
Yes.
We've got trauma. We have been rejected for far too long. And now my sisters and brothers are taking their lives because no one is listening. We graduate and want to behave like those who are perpetuating our pain. Because all we want to be is to be white. Why? The books told us so. And by being white means you don't listen to nonsense. Listen. It might be the most useless thing to listen to, but to the person who's narrating the story, it's a big issue. If you can help, help. Listen to each other. Black people love each other. It starts with listening. You can only listen if the mind is liberated and you now have love for yourself. We don't listen, we dismiss each other because we hate ourselves. The way we treat other black people, that's how we feel about ourselves.
Hey.
Let's liberate the mind so that you can have self-love. And with a self-love, you will love the next black person. You give us nonsensical services because you think we don't deserve it. Why? Because you think you don't deserve it. That's how you think of us through you. We ought to liberate the mind for you to love one another. What type of a nurse are you? Standing there when a patient is sick, there is no bed to sleep or anything or equipment. All they need is for you to stand there and wrap her back. We know there are no beds. We know there are no equipment. It is not because of the nurses. It's because the establishment is like that. It rejects black people. It won't give them beds. It's going to be fine, man. It's going to be fine. My colleague is getting you a mattress. It's going to be fine. There are no beds. Love yourself so that you can love black people. Black people, we only have ourselves. There's no one who's going to come from America. Even when they bomb us, even if they shoot us now, we won't run to anywhere. We've got nowhere to go. We only have ourselves here. We must have each other's back. We must protect one another. We must feel the pain of other black people. Because we are relatives. We are one thing. Thank you very much.